Covering Brevard County, the state wants to make sure a couple charged with child neglect will never again have custody. Titusville police say Michael Marshall and his girlfriend Sharon Glass nearly starved his 13-year-old boy and kept him locked up for days at a time. WESH 2's Dan Biller reports on the state's efforts to strip the two of parental rights.
Held without bail here at the county jail, the parents of the starved 13-year-old are not likely to have contact with him for quite some time. The Department of Children and Families wants to make sure that's forever.
He's doing well. He's on a road to recovery. He's putting on weight daily, which is one of the most important things he is.
It was 1 month ago that the boy was found on the bathroom floor of Michael Marshall's and Sharon Glass's home. Police say he looked like an inmate of a concentration camp. He was imprisoned in the bathroom and denied food and weighed just 40 pounds at age 13. His teachers believe the abuse had gone on for years.
We have feared for Corey's life for a long time. We feared for his life then. We have feared for his life ever since then.
Now DCF will start court proceedings to have parental rights stripped from Marshall, who is the father of the boy and an 11-year-old sister. Glass is the mother of a third child found in the home who was not as seriously abused. The state wants to take away her parental rights as well. Marshall's children were sent to live with Marshall's mother at first, but now are in foster care. Glass's child is now living with his father. Termination of parental rights means the abused boy and girl could be adopted by someone else and have what state caseworkers call a forever family.
We've also received calls from people who are interested in becoming foster parents for the children, and also if the parental rights are terminated, they're interested in adoption as well.
The adoption process can begin as soon as parental rights are severed, but court proceedings for that have not yet been scheduled. In Sharps, Brevard County, Dan Billow, WESH 2 News.